In this video, I'm going to show you how to remove blemishes and pimples from skin. This is a project I recently did, and I thought it would be a good little example to show you what I do when I run into skin that gives me a problem. My project settings are DaVinci Wide Gamut, Rec. 709, 2.4. My node structure is node-based, so CST. Canon, this is Canon. So Canon Log 2 goes into DaVinci Wide Gamut. And DaVinci Wide Gamut goes back to Rec. 709. These are the adjustments I made. I just did a bit of exposure, contrast, balanced it a bit, and added a bit of saturation just for this example. And now let's get into how do we fix the skin. So we can go and smooth the skin out and make it look really nice. The problem is this guy. Doesn't matter how much mid detail you take down or improve the skin tone with texture pop, that guy is not going to go away. Now there are two ways of dealing with this. And the two ways I use, the first one, you'll need the DaVinci Studio for this. I don't think it's in the free one. It's called good old Patch Replacer. Here we go, Patch Replacer. And you'll see this thing pop up. And what it does is it takes this and patches it to there. Now all we need to do is make it smaller. Put this guy, what we want covered, because it's going to patch this and put it there until we see if it looks good. Okay, so that looks pretty good. Now the tricky part is we need to track it, because on that frame it works, but if you start moving, it's not gonna be good. Normally what you do is you go to the patch positions and you keyframe it. You say keyframe. You go to the end of your shot. Go here. Go to the beginning. Go here. Now, if you are very lucky and you play through your whole clip, it works. But majority of the time, it does not. Kind of works there. I'm looking at my reference monitor here, so I can see if it's working or not. And I already know that patch replacement tool usually works, but on this specific instance, it really doesn't. I'm actually going to show you what I'm seeing right now. If I go off here, look at that forehead. Looks super strange. So the patch replacement tool doesn't work on this image. Usually it does though, so it's super handy to use. Now I'm going to talk about the second method, which I think is the best one. A, because you don't need the studio version, and I found that the results are actually better. Let's reset this node. And this is how you do it. You pick a mask. And you pick your problem area. I want to get rid of that area. You go to the tracker window, you say clip, and you say track. Third step, move the tracker or the window to a different spot that has good skin. Click on node sizing and make sure this one is selected. Sometimes I think the default is input sizing. Make sure node sizing is selected and watch what happens. We're going to take that part of the skin and put it right there. Because it is tracked, it is going to move with our subject. I'll show you the playback. So just watch here. Look how smooth that is. So smooth and it looks fantastic. 10 times better than the patch replacer tool. And that's how I fix blemishes in my footage.